Hey, this is meteorologist Darrin Harr from ilsnow.com, October 19th, 2016. Boy, oh boy, it got warm on Wednesday. Mid 70s for Indian Lake. That's just crazy warmth for mid October. And it makes you wonder if it's ever going to snow here. And believe it or not, I think it will snow on Saturday. We got a few things to go over here on this edition. First, the significant rainfalls Thursday and Friday. Then the colder over the weekend with some snow. And then November 2016. Well, I think it's going to be a mild month despite what some meteorologists might be saying. And a peek at the Siberian snow cover update here. Going to, this is the GFS projected precipitation totals through Friday. And anywhere you see this purple is 2 inches or greater of rainfall. And that's something we sorely need around here because the lakes are low, the rivers are very low. And the old timers like to say it can't snow until the swamps are full. So this is a very well needed rain here. Not quite a drought buster. You're not going to get one event to break what's been going on for several months to a year, but it's a good start anyway. And once this storm passes by, you can see it up here in the Gulf of St. Lawrence on Saturday, the colder air starts to circulate around, and you get these spokes of rain showers and snow showers pinwheeling around the counterclockwise circulation of the low. So you're going to be bringing in some lake effect snows and rain showers and orographic snow showers. And this is by Saturday here. So I think by midday Saturday, you're going to start to see the snow fly in parts of the Adirondacks. And as the temperatures get colder and drop into the 20s Saturday night, you can see some minor snows add up across the northern and western Adirondacks. Looks like about an inch or two. From the Tug Hill into the northern and western Adirondacks. For places like where I live in Indian Lake, I'll be happy if we get a slight frosting of snow out of this. But hey, you know, after temperatures reach the mid-70s this week, any amount of snow, even if it doesn't stick on the ground, would be quite a feat for us. So you know, hopefully by Sunday morning, I have a little bit to look at and maybe take a picture of. And this vortex here I'm showing you on this panel will move into eastern Canada and just kind of sit there and spin for several days. So I think the last week of October should be on the cold side. But I don't think that pattern is going to last into November. And you know, I've heard that a number of forecasters have been calling for some kind of a pattern flip going into November. And I'll tell you straight up right now, you know, I don't publicly make fun of other forecasters on my own website because I know that forecasting the weather is difficult enough. And I've seen it happen where other forecasters, they get kind of rambunctious and make fun of other forecasts. And when they're wrong, and it happens in weather, even the best of us get it wrong, people can be quite unforgiving, and that hammer just comes in and smacks you upside the head. What I prefer to do is I just tell it the way I see it. If it happens to work out and you remember that I made a good forecast and you come back to me over and over again, that's great. If I happen to be wrong, I'll admit it, and we'll just move on. I mean, forecasting the weather is problematic, you know, like forecasting the stock market or scores on a football game. You know, people lose money over that too. So right now I'm showing you this panel here. The climate models are showing a strong area of low pressure prevailing over Alaska, and that's reflective of the East Pacific oscillation, the positive phase. This is yet another oscillation that affects our weather. And when you have a positive EPO, you can see the screaming jet stream across the Gulf of Alaska into the United States. And look what the flow is doing. It's west to east. You're not allowing chunks of cold air to come in from Siberia and make way into eastern Canada. So I believe that November will be a milder than normal month. And the way things have been going, I said September was going to be mild, and it was. October is definitely going to be mild. I said it was going to be, and it is. And then I think November is going to be a mild month relative to normal. Certainly not as warm as October for obvious reasons, but I don't think November is going to be a very exciting month. And what would you like to see? Something opposite of that. And in fact, the climate models for January 2017 are showing the opposite, a negative EPO. You got the high pressure over Alaska, which allows for chunks of cold air to break off Siberia, go over the North Pole, down into eastern Canada, underneath the polar vortex. And that's how it gets cold here. I mean, take a look at the difference here. This is November, zonal flow, January, totally opposite. So based on what I see, I think think November's going to be another mild month for us. And this is climatologically what the EPO positive does for us in November here, based on analogs. Warm across the northern part of the country. The brunt of the warmth is in the north central part of the country, but the northeast United States is above normal temperature wise. And if you look and see what the climate models are predicting, look at that. I mean, I could drop the mic and walk away right now. I mean, it is a long range prediction, but for November, but it is only 10 days away, 15 days away, November. So I think the climate models generally have a decent idea within that time frame that, what the month is going to turn out generally. I mean, look at this. This is what climatologically the EPO positive does, and this is what the climate models are predicting, a very close pattern match. Now, this is what the EPO negative does in January. You can see it's a total pattern flip. Extremely cold in the north central United States and very cold for the eastern United States as a whole. Now, I want to be the first to say I'm not convinced that it would be this cold yet for January because we've been so warm for so long. The weather has to show me it's actually changing before I dive into something this cold for January. I'm not quite there yet, but what I wanted to do in this illustration was to show you that I believe that November will be mild because of this flow pattern across the North America here. Now, before I go, we gotta look at the oh, there we go, the Siberian snow cover, and you can see here it's spreading to the south very well. You can see these purple anomalies showing very good snow growth south of 60 degrees north latitude, and that's what we're looking for here. We want to see that snow cover expand to the south and eventually to the west over Asia into Europe. So I don't know. I don't think that's going to help us out early this winter, but I think over the course of the winter, I think that will mean something because the ENSO is forecasted to be a weak La Nina through the fall and then trending back to negative or a neutral over the winter. So the ENSO is probably not going to screw up the winter as it did last year with the Super El Nino. So these are things we're all going to have to watch here. And I'm not sure whether this winter is going to turn out okay, but I'm almost certain that it is going to start slow. We're going to have to be patient. And we're just going to have to keep the faith that it won't end up as bad as last winter.